Thanks for joining us here on the CBN News Channel. I'm Ephraim Graham.
And I'm Charlene Israel. A U.S. plane has crashed over Libya while trying to enforce the no-fly zone. U.S. officials say the two crew members ejected and both were rescued safely. The bombing mission over Libya has been a success, but it's not clear whether Libyan rebels can take advantage of the help, nor is it clear how long the U.S.-led coalition will stay together. Heather Sells has more.
The international coalition is shifting the focus of the no-fly zone. It's moving from the eastern part of the country west to the Gaddafi-controlled capital of Tripoli. But the U.S. insists that Gaddafi himself is not a target.
I don't know much about the location of the Libyan leader, nor have we expended any military effort in that regard.
The efforts so far have focused on destroying Libyan air defenses and stopping Gaddafi's ground forces from advancing towards the rebel stronghold of Benghazi.
We have not observed Libyan military aircraft operating since the beginning of coalition military operations.
Just how long the coalition will hang together is in question. The United Arab Emirates were going to send fighter jets, but not anymore. Norway has also now decided not to participate. And Italy had said it would open its bases to coalition countries, but it first wants to make sure NATO is put in charge of the mission, something France opposes. President Obama, on a trip to Chile, says the coalition is committed to preventing atrocities in Libya.
Democracy can't be imposed from the outside. It must spring from within.
Libyan rebels have been clearly energized by the coalition strikes, but major concerns remain about their identity and what kind of Libya they want.
There is cause for concern, I think. We don't know who we are dealing with yet, quite simply. And it's really only time will tell.
The U.S. is hoping to decrease its role in the coalition and says other countries will soon be joining. Heather Sells, CBN News.
And joining us now from our Jerusalem bureau is CBN Middle East Bureau Chief Chris Mitchell. Chris, already there is a strain on the coalition enforcing the no-fly zone. What do you think the problem is?
Well, part of that problem, Ephraim, may be confusion about the goals. Even yesterday, U.S. President Obama said his political goals were one thing, military goals were another. I know also former U.S. ambassador to the U.N., John Bolton, said, now, if Gaddafi is left in power after all this military action, it'll be a political and diplomatic disaster for the U.S. and the coalition. Also, they're getting criticism from China and Russia. Russian Prime Minister Vladimir Putin says this is like a throwback to a medieval crusade. So they're getting a lot of criticism, and it's kind of hard to have an unwieldy coalition like this going smoothly.
Well, the Arab League initially supported the no-fly zone. Why are those nations backing out now?
Well, one of the main things, I think, is that civilians have been killed in the bombing that started. And this is very difficult for the Arab League to justify to its nations. Also, I think there's a sense that the Arab League President Amir Moussa has said that it's exceeded some of the initial UN resolutions. So I think it's very hard for the Arab League to justify some of these actions to their own nations.
Chris, what specific concerns does Israel have about what's happening in Libya?
I think there's two main concerns. There was an Israeli expert today that was reported to say, who are these rebels? Many of these rebels have been in Gaddafi's regime as well, then perhaps just as bloodthirsty as Gaddafi himself. So there's a question of who are these rebels and what are their goals? The other thing I think that I think very concerning to Israel is, will the motivation that the UN had to attack Libya someday be turned against Israel itself? I think the phrase that was used in the UN resolution is that Libya had lost its legitimacy to govern. Now, with the criticism against Israel and its construction in Judea and Samaria and the West Bank, the concern, I think, for many Israelis is, will the UN one day turn against Israel and try to use military action, perhaps?
Really quickly, we're seeing reports of unrest all over the Middle East, Syria, Egypt, Yemen. What can you tell us about those places?
Well, for one thing you can tell is that the Middle East is going through a period unlike anything that I've ever seen, and that's unprecedented in its history. It's a historic change going on. For just as an example, you can see what's happening in Syria, which is unprecedented to see hundreds and thousands of people in the streets protesting against that regime. That particular regime just may hold on to power because, as one expert told me earlier today, they're not afraid to shoot their own people.
Wow. One to watch indeed. Thank you so much, Chris, for your time. We appreciate it.
Thanks, Ephraim.
Yemen's president says he is ready to step down at the end of the year in an orderly transfer of power. Ali Abdullah Saleh told senior officials and military commanders of his decision on Monday. The announcement comes after Saleh's forces opened fire on demonstrators, killing 40. The killings prompted three senior military officers to join the opposition. Three ministers and dozens of members of parliament also quit Saleh's regime in response to the massacre.
The death toll from Japan's earthquake and tsunami has now risen to more than 9,000, but it's expected to climb even higher, with nearly 13,000 people still missing. Meanwhile, the work continues at the crippled nuclear reactor as workers struggle to restore power.
There is yet another complication to bringing the Fukushima nuclear plant under control. A pool used to store spent fuel is heating up. A Japanese nuclear safety official says temperatures have risen close to the boiling point. That's believed to be causing the steam that is wafted from the plant. Meanwhile, there is mourning in Higashi Matsushima. That is where relatives gather to bury their loved ones at a mass grave. Funeral homes and crematoriums are overwhelmed. They've run out of body bags and coffins. This man says we have to get permission from the relatives before we send the dead victims to the mass grave. Still, the country is showing some signs of recovery, at least on the economic front. Tokyo stocks rose today as investors were reassured. Work to contain the nuclear crisis at the power plant were seen to be making progress. The Bank of Japan also supplied an additional $24.7 billion to the Tokyo money market to support financial institutions.
Operation Blessing is continuing to help the people of Japan. David Darg brings us up to date on efforts to keep the people in shelters warm.
Behind me, you can see the ocean and the city of Otsuchi. Operation Blessing has come here. We've continued moving north. And we've been given exceptional favor with the Japanese police and the military. And they led us to a shelter where some of the residents of this city have been living. We were able to purchase kerosene, which is the number one most needed thing in this area, because it's exceptionally cold at the moment. Without that fuel, they can't heat the shelters, and it's extremely dangerous because the temperatures are very, very low.
In just 3 days, Operation Blessing has helped 2,500 victims. You can learn more about its efforts and how you can take part at cbnnews.com.
Turning now to headlines here in the U.S., a coalition of pro-life groups is pressuring members of Congress this week to end funding for Planned Parenthood. Members of the Expose Planned Parenthood Coalition are mobilizing activists to call and visit their representatives' district offices or attend town hall meetings. The goal is to see the pro-abortion group stripped of $363 million in public funds.
Could America be experiencing a sort of sexual counter-revolution? A new study shows the number of young people who've decided to remain virgins rose from 22 to 28% in just 6 years. Another study shows the most promiscuous people are the most depressed, while those who practice sexual restraint are the happiest. Paul Strand has more.
People are starting to get organized and fight back against a sex-saturated culture. Washington Area Ministries recently celebrated an Abstinence Awareness Week with a forum entitled Sex, What They Don't Tell You. Author Tara White was the featured speaker, sharing hard lessons she learned about promiscuity from her own sad experience.
I had been dropped, broken, mishandled, and misused in a relationship. And I had felt if I had only known then the things that I know now concerning sex, marriage, and relationships, then I would have made some different choices.
Such events are telling young people a world of abstinence outside of marriage will make them happier, safer, and more fulfilled, no matter what the secular culture preaches. In that culture, one out of four youth gets a sexually transmitted disease. In parts of Washington, 82% of births are to single mothers. Richard Urban helped organize this D.C. event and says stats show kids will listen if their parents preach an abstinence message.
When we see the statistics of youth who are, you know, getting involved with sex or sexually transmitted disease or just heartbreak or pregnancy, I can't just sit around as a parent.
Author Gerard Henry took part in a Washington panel discussion on fighting promiscuity and the ills it brings.
The messaging in our culture is a pornographic message at the end of the day. So we have to be very intent on increasing this message about purity, about marriage, the value of marriage, the beauty of marriage. And again, I have to say it starts with mom and dad, husbands and wives first. And the child will want to emulate that.
Young people who abstain will find they're far from alone. New CDC stats show the number rising dramatically in the new century. Here in D.C., 42% of high schoolers have never had sex, and that's twice as many as two decades ago. Derek Cuffey is a proud 28-year-old virgin and says it doesn't cost him anything that really matters.
Sometimes you have to be prepared to maybe lose some people in your life, but if the people that you call your friends are really your friends, they will do nothing but help and support you for what you stand for.
Henry says to succeed, you have to remember who you are in God and feed that.
You are a spiritual being, not just a sexual being.
He says constant worship and chasing God will feed that spiritual being.
I was not born a loser, I was born a chooser.
And because God gave us free will and choice, Harlem preacher Michael Faulkner insists,
I can exercise that free will to abstain from my sexual lust.
Final startling stats. Girls experimenting with sex are 2 to 3 times more likely to be depressed than those who don't. And sexually active kids are more likely to drink, smoke, do drugs, get suspended, get arrested. Outside marriage, sex can hurt rather than enhance your life.
Without God's protection, sex can be destructive.
Paul Strand, CBN News, Washington.
Coming up, serving Israel, why this beautiful young woman traded her modeling career for camouflage and tanks.
Have you ever had an idea for an invention or new product? Bill Schaefer, one of the inventors of Wham-O's new Splash Wash, did. He came up with the idea while watching his children play one hot summer afternoon. Bill invented a car wash for kids. Ride through it, run through it. And Ben helped submitted the Splash Wash to Wham-O, the makers of childhood favorites like the Frisbee, Hula Hoop, and Slip and Slide. If you have an invention you would like to try to patent and submit to corporations and want free information that explains how InventHelp may be able to assist you, call now. InventHelp is America's largest invention company with sales offices in over 50 cities nationwide. Call InventHelp today for free information. Bill Schaefer made a financial gain on the Splash Wash. However, most inventions are not successful, and Bill's experience is not typical of what inventors can expect.
For your free inventor's information, call 1-800-260-7793. That's 1-800-260-7793.
I've fallen and I can't get up. I need help.
When you are home alone and have a bad fall where you cannot move, you are stuck in a very limited area. If you cannot reach a phone, you may lay helpless on the floor for hours or days, which can result in permanent incapacitation or death.
This waterproof pennant is my magic wand. To some of the paramedics, fire department, police, or my doctor, it contacts Life Alert.
When you have a heart attack like I did, and there's no one there, Life Alert was there for me. I couldn't handle the alternative of going to a nursing home.
Thanks to Life Alert, you can live alone without ever being alone. And that's why I wear one.
New Life Alert Classic for seniors or Life Alert 50 Plus.
Please call 1-800-586-0025 for a free brochure about Life Alert. That's 1-800-586-0025. Call us toll-free now at 1-800-586-0025. That number again, 1-800-586-0025.
A conservative Republican is entering the 2012 presidential race. Former Minnesota Governor Tim Pawlenty told supporters Monday he will form an exploratory committee to raise money for the run. In recent weeks, Pawlenty traveled to early primary states like Iowa. He wants to appeal to fiscal conservatives and Tea Party members. Pawlenty has openly opposed both abortion and gay rights. He was reportedly on John McCain's short list of vice presidential candidates in 2008.
Former vice presidential candidate Sarah Palin has wrapped up her 2-day visit to Israel with dinner at the prime minister's house. Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu and his wife, Sarah, hosted the private meeting with Palin and her husband, Todd. Press reports say they spoke about the Palin's tour of the Holy Land, as well as the biblical book of Esther and the Purim holiday. Palin wrote in the guest book, "Such an amazing country. God bless you. May our connection continue to grow and strengthen." This was Sarah Palin's first trip to Israel. She is known as an Israel supporter who has kept Israel's flag in her office.
Well, many evangelical Christians hold a deep attachment to Israel, supporting the nation through prayer and political involvement.
CBN Israel correspondent Julie Stahl met one Christian woman who's taken her commitment to a whole new level.
20-year-old Anna King traded a life of modeling wedding dresses and evening gowns for army fatigues.
Before the army, I was offered a few contracts in Beijing and Europe.
And I decided to turn them down to actually go into the Army.
Now, instead of posing for the camera, Anna spends her time driving a Hummer fitted as a tank on the streets of Baladia, a mock Arab village, to train Israeli soldiers for urban warfare. Anna was born in Israel to American Christian parents, so she's not obliged to serve in the IDF. But Anna wanted to do her part to serve the country.
I had a real dilemma if I wanted to be a true American and go to the States and study in college and actually develop this modeling career, or to do the Israeli path and go to the Army and study here. And I really thought about it, and I prayed about it, and I felt that this is actually what I'm supposed to do.
Deep in the Negev Desert, Baladia is the largest urban warfare training village in the world. Built with the West Bank and Gaza Strip in mind, it is also used by the U.S. and many other countries to train their troops. Anna and her unit play a crucial role in preparing those soldiers for every possible battle scenario.
I explain about the Hummer, how it comes into place, and how it's actually it's going to be a tank, basically.
Her unit is all female, about 150 of them.
There's a real spirit of, it's almost like a frat together.
She adds that sometimes telling male soldiers what to do can be a challenge.
They're always like, girls can't drive, girls don't know, girls. But usually if we're good, then at the end they say that it was the best time they had, and they had a lot of fun and they learned a lot.
But the training is more than a game.
It's like a real war. You really feel like you're in something very intense.
Fortunately, she has her faith.
I feel that God is with me here, but sometimes it's hard.
After her 2 years of service, Anna says she may go back to modeling. But for now, she's committed to spending her time on the narrow streets of Baladia. Julie Stahl, CBN News, the Negev Desert.
Up next, the incredible story of Christianity rising from the Soviet gulag, how the prayers of Russian believers are being answered more than 50 years after their deaths.
Starting a garden doesn't have to be backbreaking. Not when you have the Mantis Tiller Cultivator. It does all the hard work for you. The Mantis Tiller weighs about 20 pounds. It's easy for anyone to handle. Three convenient power options spin the patented tines deep into the soil. They dig down, cutting through the hardest clay and tangled weeds. They're so tough, they're actually guaranteed never to break. And on our two-cycle model, Mantis offers the best start engine option. It's our easiest starting two-cycle tiller ever. Tilling, weeding, and cultivating have never been easier. And now you can get this amazing Mantis Tiller Cultivator at huge savings. Order now, and we include a kickstand accessory, this border edger attachment, and free shipping. Use the Mantis for a full year, and if you're not delighted, return it for a prompt, no-questions-asked refund.
Call 1-800-707-2105 today for a free DVD and information kit. That's 1-800-707-2105.
Attention those on Medicare with diabetes. You may be eligible for an upgraded meter.
If you're tired of stabbing your fingertips to test your blood glucose, we have news that could change your life. If you're on Medicare with diabetes, then you need to know there's an alternative method for checking your blood glucose every day. You don't need to stab your fingertips anymore. The Embrace Meter from Diabetes Care Club is easier to use and nearly painless. And the best news is that Diabetes Care Club would love to send you one of these meters. This method hurts less, and because you can see and hear your results, it may be easier to understand.
Your blood glucose reading is 89.
Call now to find out why. Nearly a quarter of a million patients have joined Diabetes Care Club. Membership is free. So is the call.
Call 1-800-833-8011.
Talk to Diabetes Care Club. You'll be glad you did.
In 1949, thousands of Russian political prisoners were ordered to a Siberian labor camp to build a railway. Many died just trying to finish it.
That's right. And now a Russian pastor has honored their memory by building a church on the very spot that housed many of the prisoners. George Thomas has this incredible story.
In 1949, Stalin has reason to believe his place in Soviet history is secure.
The railway was the project of Soviet dictator Joseph Stalin.
Stalin's plan was to join the eastern and western parts of Russia. The railway started in Salekhard and ended in Igarka. Thousands of political prisoners were sent here to Salekhard to work on it.
Among them, Anatoly Marachev's grandfather.
My grandfather was labeled an enemy of the state. He was against Stalin's policies and sentenced to 10 years in a labor camp in Salekhard.
1,200 miles northeast of Moscow, Salekhard is the only town in the world that's on the Arctic Circle. Temperatures here often plummet to minus 60 degrees.
After almost 30 years of unparalleled power, Joseph Stalin dies at 74.
Construction on the railway eventually stopped in 1953 after Stalin's death, but the damage was already done. Marachev's grandfather died, along with tens of thousands of other political prisoners. Historical records show Christians were also killed in the Salekhard gulags.
We have eyewitness accounts of secret prayer gatherings. They prayed for this harsh region.
Several years ago, Anatoly Marachev moved with his family to Salekhard to honor the memory of his grandfather and the countless who died in the Siberian labor camps.
These prisoners prayed that one day the gospel will reach the peoples of this land. Today, we are seeing the fruits of their prayers.
And the fruit is the Good News Church, a thriving evangelical congregation that has risen in the heart of the Siberian tundra, led by Pastor Marachev.
People are turning to the Lord all over this region. Families are being healed, people delivered from alcohol and drugs.
And the location of Pastor Anatoly's church is very significant. You see, back in the early 50s, this exact spot used to hold thousands of political as well as religious prisoners in labor camps.
In partnership with the Association for Spiritual Renewal, which focuses on bringing the gospel to the former Soviet Union, Pastor Marachev uses his church to train the next generation of Christian leaders. Mikhailo Chernikov oversees the program.
We have a program called Schools Without Walls that's preparing young men and women to go into full-time ministry.
Good News Church is also training young people like 25-year-old Marina Shevchenko from neighboring Ukraine to be effective missionaries.
My heart is to share the gospel with the nomadic tribes. Before I can do that, I have to understand their culture. That's where Good News Church comes in. They've been working with these tribes for years.
And speaking of remote tribes, when he's not busy leading his flock, you'll find Pastor Marachev driving across the Russian tundra to reach nomadic villages with the gospel.
This is the one time in the entire year that you can actually get to this remote part of the Siberian tundra, because what we are on right now is a huge frozen lake.
It took us 4 hours today to travel less than 60 kilometers, but it was worth it. These tribes were once forgotten, not anymore.
Members of his church take regular trips to deliver food, clothes, and medical supplies. On this particular trek, Pastor Marachev will share communion with a nomadic family that he recently introduced to Jesus Christ.
I'm so happy today. We are the only Christians in this village. To take part in communion with other believers is very special for my family.
Back in Salekhard, home to some 40,000 people, Marachev is extending the church's influence to minister to orphans, the homeless, and those living with HIV/AIDS. He says this is all part of the desire to continue the legacy of those who came before him, enduring hardship and persecution, to see the gospel preached in Siberia and beyond.
That's what I stand on, those prayers of the prisoners. I believe that God's kingdom will reach the far corners of this difficult land for which our grandfathers shed their blood and prayed a long time ago for.
George Thomas, CBN News, in Salekhard, northern Siberia.
We'll be right back. Please stay with us.
Thank you.
millions of women worldwide love Bare Minerals.
This is smooth, it's nice, and it covers. I like that.
Only Bare Minerals looks like beautiful bare skin while it covers whatever you want it to. And now you can get our latest kit with our totally new, totally spill-proof Click Lock Go Foundation for over 75% off retail. Our new kit comes with Bare Minerals Foundation in the shade that's just right for you. Warmth for a healthy glow. Mineral Veil, the ultimate finishing touch, and Bare Minerals Flawless Application Brush. Call now and get three full-size gifts worth $57.95 free. Purchased separately, you'd spend over $120. Our original Get Started Kit was a great deal at two payments of $29.99. But now you can get all this for just one payment of $29.99. Save over $90 and get a 30-day money-back guarantee.
Call 1-800-376-4174. Ask how you can receive this handy compact. Call 1-800-376-4174 now.
If you have diabetes and you're on Medicare, call now for a new pain-free meter. These new meters are more accurate, they're easier to use, and the best news is you don't have to prick your fingers anymore. Call now, and Arriva Medical will send you one of these new meters for free. And if you have Medicare, your testing supplies may also be covered. Arriva makes it simple. They bill Medicare directly. There are no upfront costs. And they deliver your supplies right to your door for free. With these new meters, there's no coding, you don't have to prick your fingers, and some of these meters even talk.
Your blood glucose reading is 122.
And if you call 1-800-284-9762, we will send you a free Betty Crocker Diabetes Cookbook filled with delicious recipes.
Call Arriva today. You'd be glad you did.
It is never too late to say thank you. At least that's the way one World War II era man sees it.
That's right. He is sending postcards to Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, in hopes they reach three soldiers who helped him more than 50 years ago. Back in 1948, Horst Fell was just a 10-year-old kid struggling to survive in Germany. It was the kindness of three American soldiers who kept his family alive. Now the German resident wants to thank them. He mailed the letters to the Pittsburgh City Council, hoping they could help them find the men.
He actually and his family were starving as children, and these soldiers had helped them. Even at Christmas time, they bought gifts for the children, hoping that we can find one of these three soldiers.
Now, the mystery soldiers continued to send care packages every month for 3 years during the war. Feld believes it's now his call of duty to finally say thank you. That's pretty cool.
Nice. Good manners, too.
Yes.
That is going to do it for this hour of the CBN News Channel. You can find more of today's top headlines, along with exclusive coverage of the issues you care most about, at CBNNews.com.
And remember, you can also stay up to date with CBN News through Facebook and Twitter. We hope you'll join us next time. Have a great day, and God bless.
Have you ever had an idea for an invention or new product? Bill Schaefer, one of the inventors of Wham-O's new Splash Wash, did. He came up with the idea while watching his children play one hot summer afternoon. Bill invented a car wash for kids. Ride through it, run through it. And Ben helped submitted the Splash Wash to Wham-O, the makers of childhood favorites like the Frisbee, Hula Hoop, and Slip and Slide. If you have an invention you would like to try to patent and submit to corporations and want free information that explains how InventHelp may be able to assist you, call now. InventHelp is America's largest invention company with sales offices in over 50 cities nationwide. Call InventHelp today for free information. Bill Schaefer made a financial gain on the Splash Wash. However, most inventions are not successful, and Bill's experience is not typical of what inventors can expect.
For your free inventor's information, call 1-800-260-7793. That's 1-800-260-7793.
Finding video on CBN.com just got easier. We've taken all our video, the 700 Club, news, testimonies, teachings, plus our 24/7 channels, and put them in one convenient location, CBN TV. Watch what you want, when you want. It's all simple to find, and now easier than ever to email a story to a friend. CBN TV on CBN.com.